video, I'll show you how to add social share button on your website or your blog post so that your visitors can easily share your content on their social media platform. First of all, make sure to download the Explore Elementor add-ons. I'm adding the link in the description below on how to download Explore add-ons on WordPress. Let's create social share button for this page. Simply, we're gonna search for social share from the widget panel. Drag and drop the widget here. Under the general section, by default, there are three icons over here. If you want to add more icons, you can add an item from here, like this. Now choose the network. As an example, I'm choosing WhatsApp. You can see. Now you can choose whether you want to enable the title or not. I'm enabling the title to show you how it works. As an example, I'm writing here WhatsApp. It is the title of the icon, like this. Next, you can add the custom link and you will be able to direct your visitors to the social media platforms by clicking on this icon. Like this. Moving to the next option, here we have post custom title option. From here, you can add the title for your post. Just suppose I'm writing here, story of innovation in electronics. Yeah, you can see. Now this will be the title that will appear on my post. And if you want to give different colors to each icon, then enable this inline style option. Let me show you how it works. I'm choosing the icon color to white and the background color to black. Now move to the hover. Again, I'm choosing the icon color to white and the background color to light blue, like this. Now we have the alignment option. From here, you can adjust the alignment where you want the icons, right, center, or left. I'm choosing it to the left, like this. Next, we can adjust in how many columns we need the icons, depending on the numbers and alignment of your icon. Look, if I'm choosing one, then it's aligned vertically on the left side. I'm choosing it to the 4. Now it's aligned in one row. Now let's do some styling of our widget. Now move to the styling tab. Let's do some styling of our widget. Under the general section, here we have a column gap and row gap. Simply drag the slider to see the difference. As we have aligned it horizontally, we can adjust the column gap according to our need. I'm choosing it to 25. Now we have the color of the icon and the background. Let's choose the icon color first. I'm choosing the icon color to white and the background color to black. Now move to the hover. Now we can choose the hover colors. I'm choosing the icon color to white and the background color to light blue. Yeah, like this. You can see? Now we have the border colors. But first, we need to choose a border type. Let's choose a border type to solid, like this. Let's do double to show you. You can see, and then we can choose the border color, but currently I don't need any border. Now let's have fun exploring these hover animations. Let's try this one, 2D, and wow, you can see when we hover, the size of this icon, it increases. Now let's choose the background animation, background hover animation. Yeah, it's a bit boring. Let's try the unique. Wow, it's interesting. Hope you are getting it in the right way that how these animations will work. Let's choose it to the none because I'm good without these animations. Next, we have this box shadow. From here, you can add shadow to these icons. You can see the shadow. Oops, it's too much. I'm just showing you how it works. Now we will choose the border radius. I'm choosing the border radius to 10. Let's do some padding of these icons. I'm choosing the padding to 15, like this. It looks better now, right? Now move to the icon section. From here, we can adjust the size and background size of this icon. Simply drag the slider to see how it works. I'm setting the icon size to 25. Now the background size, I'm setting it to the 10. Yeah. Like this. Lastly, move to the title section. From here, we will adjust the title's typography. Let's change the fonts family. As always, I'm choosing Poppins like this. Now adjust the size. I'm setting it to 12. And wow, it looks amazing. Now we can adjust the weight of this text. I'm choosing light like this. We can also adjust the transform, style, and decoration. Let's adjust the line height like this. You can see. Now adjust the letter spacing. Feel free to have fun with these options for more adjustments. Lastly, you can adjust the title space like this. I'm setting it to 15. And we are done with our social share buttons. Let's have a final look. And wow, it looks great, right? Feel free to ask any question and let me know in the comments below on which around I should make my next video. Your support means everything. Like and subscribe for more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.